the Brain Tumor Center here at Wake Forest really has state-of-the-art technology in really every area of brain tumor care. From a surgical standpoint, we have really the most novel surgical techniques and equipment available in the operating room. In radiation oncology, again, state-of-the-art treatment facilities, including the newest version of the Gamma Knife. We have a decades-long tradition of carrying out clinical research in cancer patients at large, and really almost a two-decade history of doing multidisciplinary research for brain tumor patients. So we really know how to take novel therapies, newer approaches, newer techniques, bring them to our patients, do them safely, and monitor them carefully. We have been members of a National Cancer Institute-funded brain tumor consortium. It's currently called the Adult Brain Tumor Consortium, and its predecessors for, again, over almost 15 years. And that has allowed us to take really the newest in technology, the newest in cytotoxic therapy, the newest in targeted agents, all sorts of approaches to combat brain tumors and bring them here to Winston-Salem to use in our patients and to try to help our patients as they battle these sort of terrible diseases. The Adult Brain Tumor Consortium is made up of about 16 of the finest brain tumor institutions in the country. Really across, it spans the country from University of California in San Francisco, MD Anderson, Memorial Sloan Kettering, Dana-Farber, Mass General, Johns Hopkins, and down here in the south, Wake Forest. And so we have had the ability to collaborate with some of the best institutions in the country, and again, to bring some of those state-of-the-art new treatments to our community. We have also been very active in running clinical trials and testing new ideas that originate right here from investigators at Wake Forest, either from the clinical side or from the laboratory side. Finally, we have, because of our reputation in clinical research, we get approached by many of the industry partners around the country who are looking to test their new approaches, new techniques, and new therapies. And one of which is a very exciting trial that we've just activated, looking at vaccine therapy for patients with newly diagnosed glioblastoma, a very malignant form of brain tumor. The concept of this trial, it not only involves getting the immune system to fight cancer, but getting the immune system not to fight any cancer cells, but something called cancer stem cells. The current theory is that a tumor is made up of a bunch of different cells, but only a small population of them really are the mama cells, the ones that give birth to litter after litter of new tumor cells. And it's thought that rather than targeting that whole mass of baby tumor cells, as it were, if we really want to stop tumors or get rid of them, we need to go after the mama and daddy cells, the ones that generate those new tumor cells. And those are called tumor stem cells. They're present probably in every tumor, and there's been a huge amount of work in brain tumors showing that there are such cells in glioblastomas in particular. For patients who are eligible for the trial, we actually remove dendritic cells, those immune processing cells, from their body, expose it to a certain panel of antigens, and those antigens or proteins are present not only on tumor cells at large, but are also heavily expressed on the tumor stem cells. We then grow those cells out of the body, get them excited about fighting those particular antigens, and then give them back to the patient. So this particular vaccine approach is novel in that, number one, it uses circulating dendritic cells, an antigen-presenting cell, but more importantly, it tries to get those cells to target antigens or proteins or surface molecules that are present not only on tumor cells at large, but on the stem cells, the one that we think keeps that tumor coming back and growing. The preliminary results with that type of an approach in smaller studies has been very exciting, but that really doesn't prove anything. To prove it, you need a larger study, and you need a study where, again, half the patients get the vaccine, half the patients don't, where the patient arms are as well matched as possible, and we're doing that study now. We're one of about 16 to 20 institutions around the country involved in this particular study, and we're very, very excited about the potential to really open up a new window, a whole new modality of treating these tumors, trying to get the best system to fight off infection, the immune system, to try to turn that into the best way to fight off cancer.